Hi everyone, Marine here for FAWN. Welcome to this new video. Today we are getting spooky with the Fangtastic friends. We are going to stencil a slimline panel and then turn it into a magic picture changer Halloween scene. And today's card was actually a request by several people on Instagram. I was asked to recreate those two cards I posted during release week in August. So obviously we're starting today with the card on the left, and to bring more fun, I'm going to change the shape and the colors, but the process remains the same. And next time I will share a card using the same background as the one on the right. So first, let's check out the supplies I'm going to use in this video. We have the Fangtastic Friends and the add-on stamp sets, the small witch hat and pumpkin bucket from Holiday Party Animal, the magic picture changer and add-on die sets, and one of my favorite new products, the nighttime sky stencil. So if you watched my other magic picture changer cards, you already know that I like to start with the background. No matter what the size of the panel, I always, always do the background first. Here I needed to know where the moon would be, so I placed all my stamped and die-cut images on my panel, as well as the frame die, and I traced the window on my panel using a pencil, and this is where I'm going to make the moon. I am going to use the circle from the nighttime sky stencil, and I don't have a repositional spray glue to keep this circle in place, so I'm just using pieces of washi tape that I'm rolling and attaching at the back of the circle. And you can see through the circle, so it's easy to center it on top of the pencil marks. And now we're going to make a purple sky. I'm going to use shaded lilac, wilted violet, villainous potion and black soot oxidings. I'm starting with the lightest color around the stencil, and then I add the other colors. And to blend two colors together, I'm doing circle motions to emphasize the glow around the moon, but also the kind of foggy effect. At the beginning, it doesn't look that good, but you will see that by coming back and forth several times with the blending tools, you can achieve a pretty cool background. I'm leaving the whole inking process so you can see the evolution. So the inking is done. I'm going to splatter some water all over the panel, and I want to add more details, but first we're going to make this purple sky even more spooky by adding some clouds. I'm using the Nighttime Sky stencil to randomly add clouds on the panel, and I'm applying a white pigment ink using a sponge dauber. Now let's add more texture on that cloudy purple sky, starting with some liquid stardust splatters to make the panel super shiny. So here's a close-up look at the panel. I let it dry for a few minutes, and then I taped the Nighttime Sky stencil on top of it to create the moon, and I wanted it to really pop in the purple sky, so I'm using yellow oxide inks to color that moon. I'm first applying squeezed lemonade all over the moon. Next, I'm adding mustard seed, but just on the edges. And then I'm coming back with my squeezed lemonade blending tool to blend the inks from the edges towards the middle of the moon. Now let's add some details to the moon. I moved the stencil and aligned the small circle shapes with the moon. And I'm using mustard seed again to create those details. So let's see how it looks. It really looks like the moon is glowing, perfect. Now, I want the interactive window to be where the moon is, and I want that window to be centered on the moon. So to place the frame die at the right spot and centered on the moon, I'm using the bat with the open wings. I'm placing that bat right in the middle of the moon. Next, I can line up the frame die window with the bat. I tape the frame die and remove the bat. And then I can send the panel to my die-cutting machine to cut a frame out of it. And here we go. Of course, we're keeping the frame, but also the square because we're going to use it later in the process. But now let's work on the interactive panels. We have a long one for the pocket die and a short one for the moving piece die. And I'm starting by tracing both windows using a pencil. And next, I'm going to stamp the bats. On the long panel, I'm stamping the one with the folded wings. And on the short panel, I'm stamping the one with the open wings. And now I'm going to color those cute bats using my alcohol markers. Here the paper is Strathmore Bristol cardstock. I always use that paper to make the interactive part. The markers don't bleed on it. And the mechanism always works perfectly.
Thank you.
So we're done with those bats. Off screen, I erased the pencil frames, but I kept the corners. I also used the coordinating dies to cut a mask for each bat. So first, I'm going to stick those masks. I'm placing them on the images. And to make sure that the mask is centered properly on the image, I use the lights above my desk to see through the mask. Now we need to create the same moon background behind those bats as the one on the square. So just like before, we're starting with squeezed lemonade oxide ink to create the base of the moon. Next, I taped the stencil with the bat in the middle of the circle. And I'm adding mustard seed oxide ink on the edges. And I'm blending with my squeezed lemonade blending tool. Now, and here is why I didn't erase the pencil corners. I'm placing the square between those corners. I keep the square in place with washi tape. Next, I line up the moon details on the stencil with the ones on the square. I remove the square and tape the stencil. And then I use mustard seed oxide ink again to add those moon details on the pocket panel. And we can see here that it looks quite nicely. Now let's remove the mask. Our pocket panel is done. So we can move on to the moving piece panel and repeat the exact same steps to create the same moon background behind the bat. And the second panel is done. Now let's bring the dies back. I'm lining them up with the pencil corners and taping them with washi tape. I send them to my die cutting machine, and here we go, perfect. Now we can build the interactive pocket. First, we need to fold the pocket panel in half, right on the score line, and next the slim tabs on both sides. I'm using a bone folder to press really well and create a sharp fold. Next, I'm adding double-sided tape on those tabs, on the front and at the back as well. I'm removing the backing papers of the inside of the tabs, so I can fold and stick those tabs at the back of the pocket panel, just like so. Next, a step that I never miss. I like to apply a generous amount of powder at the back of the panel, on the flaps in the middle, and along the tabs as well. And I also like to rub the edges of those two pieces to make the edges less sharp. Those steps really help to make the mechanism work better. Now let's put the moving piece tab into the pocket panel slot. Next, each little flap into a small slot, just like so. We pull on the tab to interlock the flaps and slots. At the back of the panel, we make sure that the moving piece is aligned between the tabs. Now we can remove the remaining backing papers and fold the pocket panel to close it and totally complete the mechanism. Next, I'm adding double-sided tape at the back of the frame on the four edges. And I attach that frame on the pocket, and everything lines up beautifully. It's very nice. See, super cute. And before coloring more bats, we need to assemble a few things. I cut a purple textured dot slimline card base. and I'm first attaching the panel using 1 mm from squares. As you can see, I embossed my sentiment at the bottom of the panel in silver and white. And then I'm tucking and sticking the pocket right in the hole using 1 mm from squares again. And our spooky interactive purple panel is done. So we can move on and color some extra images to make this Halloween scene super cute and fun. So the images are done. I'm going to stick them on the card using foam squares mostly. And for this branch, I'm just making sure that the foam squares are placed outside the window, otherwise they would interfere with the mechanism. So once everything was attached, I added highlights and details on the images using my white gel pen. And the last final step is to add the decorative handle piece on the pull tab. I cut the main piece out of shimmery purple cardstock. I'm using liquid glue to stick it at the end of the pull tab. And for the arrow, I went with fake tan cardstock to match the pumpkin buckets. And we are done. This is the final result. I love it so much and I hope that you guys like it too. I really love how the whole scene turned out. Thank you so much for stopping by. And see you next time. Have a very nice day. Bye.